And so we come together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
As we gather around God's table, we're mindful of how the salvation for us has been won by Jesus Christ. Mindful, too, of the times we have denied Him, the times we have sinned, as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you come to us in word and in sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
God said, ask something. riches, not for the life of your enemies, but for understanding, so that you may know what is right. I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now, and after you there will come no one to equal you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
person finds and finds again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul it ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus, it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Do you understand these things? They answer, yes. And he replied, then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household, who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus, once again, talking to his disciples and others, talking to us about just what the kingdom of heaven is like. And there certainly could be a few reasons why he's taking so much time to do this. Not the least of which is he realizes that the disciples just didn't get it. For that matter, we probably don't necessarily get it. As well as the fact that the kingdom of heaven is really, really a big deal. It is. Last week I suggested that the kingdom of heaven can appear to be very slow and happy, small and seemingly insignificant, even messy. But even in messy times, the sower continues to sow good seed and intends for wheat to grow among the weeds. Among the mess. For the sower is patient. The sower is trusting that there will be a harvest. Friends, that's our God. God who plants the seed in us and in this messy kingdom, trusting that it will grow, it will prosper, it will bear fruit, it will be worthy of that harvest yet to be when the fullness of the kingdom at last is made real. And no amount of mess, no amount of weeds can get in its way. Now this week, we have no less than three parables in this one gospel passage. The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field which a person finds, hides out of joy, sells all that they have, and buys the field. The kingdom of heaven is also like a merchant who searches for and finds a pearl of great price. Again, he sells everything he has, buys it. But the kingdom of heaven is also like a net thrown into the sea, collecting fish of every kind, the good are kept, the bad are thrown away. Now certainly, the commonality is that the kingdom of heaven is of immense importance and value. It is, after all, something you and I are engaged in right now. But yet, to be fully realized, will only be fully realized at the end of time. But there's also some differences. You see, in the parable of the treasure, the man isn't looking for it, but he finds that field by chance. In the parable of the pearl of great price, the merchant is putting a lot of effort and time to find the pearl. And in the parable of the net thrown into the sea, they're collecting a fish of every kind. Those fishing are just simply engaged in what they do day in and day out. They're normal activity. Lessons to be learned. The kingdom of heaven is God's doing. It don't bring it about, God's already inaugurated it. And there will be days when we just stumble upon glimpses of it, like that man in the field. Days when it powerfully presents to us itself, despite the fact that we're not even looking for it. Then there will also be those days when we, like the merchant, search for it. And we do, in fact, find it. But there will also be days when, just in the normal course of events and the usual routine, we will stop and take pause to sort through the messiness, because we know that amid that, there is a glimpse of the kingdom of heaven. A glimpse of what is good, beautiful, and hopeful. Now add to this lesson learned the fact that especially in these messy times when we easily can grow weary of life, we should never stop searching for the best of the kingdom. It's here, in our midst. But in the event we do, in the event that we become so weary that we're convinced God has somehow pulled the plug on those joyful experiences of the kingdom, we should never stop being hopeful. For even amid our daily routine, even amid our weariness, even amid our despair, the kingdom of heaven is at hand, present in our midst. And God intends for there to be a fruitful harvest. God intends to save us and to provide us our heart's desire. Good news, God is still in charge. Be confident of this. Be assured of this. And whether we're looking for God or not, God's always looking for us. And patiently waiting. Waiting for the opportunity to reveal to us just a little bit more of his presence. So that we might care more. So that we might believe more deeply. And God never fails nor abandons that pursuit. God indeed is always successful.
Seek to serve the common good of all people. We pray.
Lord, hear
your kingdom to us, a treasure hidden in a field, a pearl of great price. Grant us your Spirit's gift of discernment, that we may learn to distinguish aright between the passing wealth of this present world and the enduring value of your kingdom. Then make us swift to renounce all else to acquire the treasure you alone can bestow. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory chant, we sing together, Drawn to You, and it's number 398.
The Lord be with you. so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "He peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace.
Communion chant, let's sing together the body of Christ, and it's number 326.
Thank you.
blood of Christ.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
This is the body of Christ.
The body of Christ. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Always thank you to those giving up their time and their talent to support your parish's mission and ministry. Also, the gift of treasure. Monthly users, we continue to remind you, please, to remember the collection boxes at the entrance of the church. Don't forget your bulletins this weekend. You'll find hidden in there the winning numbers for the mega money. So, you know, if you've never read a bulletin before, maybe you will this weekend. Let me know if you find one. Also, take prizes in your entrances of the church. Praise God, the cupola has gotten up this week. So if you haven't had a chance to take a peek, just kind of like look up. They look very nice. The company did an excellent job. They were in and out over the course of 2 full days. But they really did a great job. So that's one thing to check off the list. And update on the sound system. It's fried. Okay, there are parts of it that are fried. So right now, this is really the only speaker in church that's working. Microphone jacks and all that. We're not sure what the outcome or the final assessment is going to be, but we'll do the best we can. So if you're wondering why you can't hear as well, perhaps over there than you normally do, that's because that speaker's not working. There's two speakers, maybe two-thirds of the way down, up in the rafters. Those aren't working. You name it, it's probably not working. So just give us a chance. We have to get together with those folks, we hope, next week and find out what some of the options are. Thank you. The Lord be with you. And Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Be on peace, Lord, by the Lord, by your life.
Thanks be to God. Can we sing Go Make a Difference? And it's number 499.